Hi everybody, this is Nerdcore Limit, and we're going to talk about something interesting it called bait and switch, and especially in media. There's other words for that, and they call com, racket, ripoff. Those are the most common ones. But what is actually bait and switch? Bait and switch is to pursue someone to buy or do something, bait, and then changing the terms on the arrangement after the deal is done, switching. It's supposed to be only in retail, selling houses, or in dealers, but it's not. There's other areas that start doing it, and it's in Hollywood. And one of the ones who is controversial so far on that is Kevin Smith. He say he's a super fan of He-Man, of the Master of the Universe, for back in 1980. He promised to the people he's gonna create the greatest show ever, and obviously create the one called Netflix Masters of the Universe Revelation. And for a subscription of Netflix, you will show this show. Yes, on Netflix. What a coincidence. And that's the bait, telling the people go and subscribe, because companies are desperate for people coming over there. When the show air, guess what? It is not. It's a completely opposite of what he said. That's the switch. And Kevin Smith and He-Man is one of the samples of the beginning of the bait and switch terminology or media. And the idea behind bait and switch is to draw customers with an attractive proposition and fail to deliver. Netflix is one of them with a different shows. HBO Max is getting there. Amazon Studios, The Lord of the Rings, bad. And Disney Plus has the Marvel and the Star Wars franchise. And Paramount Plus start doing with Halo and obviously with Star Trek franchise. When the companies are desperate, they bring in garbage. They're supposed to be listening what the audience want, but it's not. They're just supposed to be making money and bringing completely trash. We're gonna show you the samples of how to spot a fake and switch show, movie, follow the samples. And our first one is Halo for Paramount Pictures. Halo from Paramount Pictures is one of the samples right now of typical bait and switch technique. And I will show you the video briefly how they start telling the story.
When Halo Combat Evolved released for the original Xbox in 2001, Halo at its core is the story of the heroic super soldier Master Chief. But I'm even better when I'm embedded within Master Chief's neural matrix to offer real-time tactical guidance.
Okay, if you see that, Paramount tried to tell the audience in a small video they know what is the lore of Master Chief, which one is a lie. That's a bait. Also, another bait is the interviews. What is Halo means to me? Listen.
It's like you might have watched a superhero. You know, it's literally like that.
Heroic, upstanding, you know.
Fascinating glimpse into the human psyche, human behavior.
I love this fully fleshed out world that I get to feel like I have a place in and understand and am part of.
So Halo is more than just a video game, and it's more than just like a franchise to me.
It really talks about the big issues in a very sci-fi way, and it's...
If you notice, all of the actors do not know what they're talking about or what is Master Chief or Halo means to me.
Especially my character in this story, Halo, you know, she fights for what she believes in, and, you know, Master Chief also fights for what he believes in.
And also in the end, the female actress, instead of talking Halo, is talking about herself. It's like, okay, they're contradicting self of the question. Now, on the red carpet, you will see how the people of Paramount try to deceive, showing different shot of supposed to be the fans, they just bring it briefly, and you will notice how empty is the area. They talk about the Warhawk, they talk about the actors, they talk about the Warhawk, but then none of them, they talk about what is Halo, the show. That's another indication of that. That's the reason it's really important to listen the interviews or behind the scenes of the show. That's the first clue about how bad the show it is. Is the producer do not know what they're talking about, and directors and even the actors, you know, is garbage. There you go. That's part one of bait and switch. On part two, we show you how to spot that technique of bait and switch in posters, trailers, and how you know this is actually the using the trick and bait and switch and which ones they're not, based on posters and trailers. And also you need to pay attention on the interviews, like the ones we saw right now on Halo. When the actors and directors start difficulty explaining, that's when you know that's a one red flag. Also, there's other places you found the bait and switch, and believe it or not, most people don't see it, but it's in actually in the toys. They give you a huge clue on that. Plus, in the bait and switch, they follow four simple rules of how to bring the audience from something they're not good, or the producers, they know it. It is utterly garbage. But this is Nerdcore Unlimited, and we'll see you on part two of bait and switch techniques. And see you soon.